6 p.m. Welcome everyone to our board meeting of July 21st, 2020. If you're saying, Mr. Hess, we have a presentation today.
Lord, we thank this day. Lord, we thank this opportunity to come together to work with the county. Lord, we pray that you be with us and guide us. Lord, we pray that you forgive us our sins, to protect us, to protect our country. Lord, we pray that you put your hands on all of us. Bless us with the Lord. All this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
For the leaders, to the God, and the United States of America, to the Lord, and the Lord, and the Saints, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Once again, I'd like to welcome everyone. At this time, I'm gonna have a little bit of change on the agenda. I'm gonna have Mr. Powell come up with a presentation of the audit of this year ended September 30, 2019. Welcome, sir.
It's a pleasure delivering the annual audit of Suwannee County. The audit this year was a challenge, and it was not because of any issues with finances, it was access. And so everyone worked with us, and we were able to get completed and do a complete job. I have kind of a handout, some audit slides that I'll use instead of going through all 300 pages of the audit report, which you have. On page 2 and 3, says that in the audit opinion, it states that we conducted a full financial audit of the county, which includes the board and each of the 5 constitutional officers. In an audit, what you see is a clean, unmodified opinion that that states that depending on the financial statements, the county has this highest level of assurance, which is a good reflection on the quality of its financial records, internal control procedures of the board and constitutional officers. The next section, called management's discussion and analysis, page 11 through 17, contains certain required overview information on the county due to the fact that it is derived from the financial statements. In the interest of time, I request that you read this section on your own, and I will go directly to the pertinent financial statements. And on page 23, the county, obviously a unit of government, operates under government fund accounting. There's three types of funds, but the operating funds are the governmental funds. waste collection fund, yeah, that is better. The solid waste collection fund is, these basically operate off special assessments. So the solid waste collection, so when you put them together, you're positive about $300,000. And year to year, depends on the allocation of the solid waste special assessment. But again, these funds are positive for the year. On page 13 is a table that shows the capital assets of the county, the governmental assets that cost $149,509,835, accumulated appreciation $66,265,000, the net assets $83.8 million, the percent appreciated of these assets is 44.6%. So of the counties of which I'm aware, you're in the average to slightly newer assets, so that's good. On your business type though, the total is a little over $9 million, it costs $6.5 million, accumulated depreciations of $2.5 million, so that these assets are over, they're about 72%. Overall, when you combine your assets, are about 45.9, 46% depreciated. So your assets are average to slightly newer than other counties in your size range. On page 14 is the debt of the county, and you can see in the governmental that the revenue bonds and loans are $6,665,646, but only represent 14.3% of your total long-term liabilities. The balance are the payroll related liabilities of compensated absence, OPEB, and your the proportionate share of the FRS pension liability, which your share is now almost $30 million. On page 15 is the business, it is a business type debt. Capital lease debt, $313,562. Comp absences, $105,000. The landfill closure, post closure liability is now $1.5 million. And then there, the enterprise fund's share of FRS liability, $929,000. So financially, I would say that you had a successful year. You were stronger at the end of the year in both your governmental funds and your enterprise funds. As I mentioned, our audit included financial auditing standards, government auditing standards, federal single audit standards, and state single audit standards. So you had the four levels of required audit procedures. So on page 96-97 of our report regarding procedures required by government auditing standards, these procedures go beyond just financial numbers and include internal control over financial reporting, compliance with various laws, regulations, contracts, and related matters. This report contains no findings or question calls relating to these procedures. On page 17 in this year, you, because of the level of grant activity, it required a single audit for both your federal grants and state grants. And on this page 17 shows which grants were the major programs that additional audit procedures were performed on them. In this report, we had no findings or questions regarding those audit procedures. The management letter is on page 108-110. Management letter is required by rules of the Auditor General and contains any findings, recommendations that were not included in the previous reports, but items of which we wish to make the board and constitutional officers aware of. In this letter, there were no On page 111, we're required to do, perform audit procedures regarding four items, the county and officers' investment of public funds, E911 grant compliance, clerk's court-related budgetary compliance, clerk's compliance to state court performance standard. We performed these procedures and had no findings regarding these matters. So I would say, again, always pleased when a government client has no findings. That's good. Everyone works very hard to correct prior findings and to maintain the corrective measures. So be pleased to answer any questions.
Does anyone from the board have any questions or comments, Mr. Powell?
I'm satisfied with the government. Like I previously said, kind of before that meeting, I don't know if you know about the figures, but that's your job to do it. You do a good job, a great job there.
I appreciate that. But it's actually the staff, all of the staff that come up with the figures, we audit them and re-compile them. So it's a cooperative effort. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Powell, for the thorough report.
Good.
We appreciate you.
Good. And I appreciate all this time, so thank you.
Yes, sir.
I can go to my next meeting.
Absolutely. At this time, we'll get back on our regular schedules for item number one, approval of minutes from July 7th, 2020. Board meeting, do I have any questions, comments? Do I have a motion to approve? Motion to approve by Commissioner Gaines, second by Commissioner Richardson. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Next is July 14th, special power meeting of 2021. I'm sorry. Do I have any questions, comments, or do I have a motion? Got a motion by Commissioner Richardson, second by Commissioner Hill. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. At this time, we go to the consent agenda. I'm pulling item 13 on the request of Commissioner Richardson for discussion. At this time, items 2 through 12 and then 14 and 15. Do I have any questions or comments? Do I have a motion to approve those items?
Motion to approve.
Got a motion by Commissioner Gamble?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Hill. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. At this time, we'll open discussion on item 13. I'll read it. Authorization to utilize chip seal funds to pay with asphalt a portion of 161st Road from US 90 to 68th Street. Commissioner Richardson.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Everybody, please pull the mics close. These kind of like paperwork in front, you just have to put it inside a little bit before you hear it.
I know this is the road that has been, we've attempted to get paved over the years, and going back by the way, I don't have a problem with the road itself. But in looking into this, I questioned the current balance of our chip seal fund, and come to find out that our budget did not reflect the entire $750,000 for this year, nor did it reflect the rollover funds from last year that were not spent because of jobs not being created. So I request that Keith look into this, and I would like to just simply hold off on making a decision on this one until we have finance has report on where the funds are or what happened to them. And it's just one of those things that it looks to me, we have, according to Mr. Harris, we have spent money out of the chip seal program this year, out of that was part of that funding for this year. But there is a big gap that was not completed until this year from last year's allocation. And we made it very clear in the budget hearings that this would be in addition to the $750,000 budget amount would be in addition to whatever was not spent out of the prior years. I'm just asking you to go off
my thoughts on it, Mr. Richardson. I would ask that we be able to go ahead and move forward with the payments in Southwest Israel. And I understand these numbers and where they lay, maybe workshops could clarify that and understand. I mean, it's still going to be going to be paid or not paid, but it's. And I think you're going to pay this for something.
I have some answers, but we have to go to our constituents about why Chip's Hill roads can't be done this year because of expectation of low revenues, gas tax revenues, that we allocated some of that money aside already. And I recognize the responsibility of that. I do recognize also that this is a net much needed project. And I also understand that Mr. Hale did not ask for any roads, any CHIPS program roads this year anyway. This is really his project. So I'm willing to concede so long as there's an understanding that I believe there's a problem here with the budget. And I would like to have those numbers figured out. Because $401,000 is off the low. Just a few weeks ago, we were talking about it and said we're not spending $7,000 anyway because of right now, all in all, the CHIPS program. So, yes,
sir. And I appreciate you guys, appreciate you, Mr. Richardson, understanding that. I do not remember what you said. It's not what I think this property. But to look at that, I agree with you.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes,
just everyone's
a little better.
Yeah.
So I appreciate you going to see me that, but if there's other funds that we need to try to find, Mr. Harris, I'm sure you'll run around for some to what's going on.
Well, I'll tell you this. No funds were lost. What happened to any funds that were not reflected on your chip steel line and your green bar, that's what I looked up when Commissioner Richardson called me earlier, are going to be in your general fund. So that's where they ended up.
Proposed not to exceed the millage rate for 2021 fiscal year. Current
current year gross actual value for Suwannee County is $1,950,125,299. Current year rollback rate is 9.0823 mils. The rollback rate is the rate that would generate prior year tax revenues less allowances for the new construction, additions, deletions, annexations, and improvements. Each mill generates approximately $1,950,125. Last year, this time, the U.S. Board said it's proposed not to exceed the millage rate of 9.000 mills. As a reminder, once you set the proposed millage, it's a proposed not to exceed the millage rate tonight. It's rate you can lower it any time between now and the and final budget hearing, but you cannot raise the millage rate after you set it tonight. Is there any questions?
I have any questions, Mr. Baker.
I'll just point out that according to the schedule, it looks like if you say the 9 mills, you would generate $152,471 less than the current year.
Correct. Okay. I have any discussion from the board?
I did run some numbers. I'll just tell you, I did run some. This rollback rate, 9.0823, if you were to utilize that to generate approximately the same money that you did in the current year, that's a little bit less than 1/10 of a mill. And when I ran some numbers on 1/10 of a mill earlier, I think it came to about 83 cents a month.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we keep the millage rate at 9.00. I have a motion by Commissioner Richardson.
Go ahead.
Second.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Gamble. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. So it's 9 bills. Thank you, Mr. Baker.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to go ahead and simply talk about scheduling the tentative and final budget hearings as well, if we can handle that now as part of this discussion. We've got a proposed tentative budget hearing of Thursday, September 10th, and all of this, as a reminder, by way of reminder, is predicated on when the school board handles their budget. So that's where these dates came from. They're not just arbitrary dates. But the tentative budget hearing would be Thursday, September 10th at 5:30 at the Judicial Annex. And the final budget hearing, Tuesday, September 22nd at 5:30 at the Coliseum.
What's the second date?
The second date is Tuesday, September 22nd at 5:30. And that will be here. And this is a reflection of checking all the dates and all the locations and everyone else's schedule, checking on the school board and all the work that we're trying to select dates that actually work so that we can get this accomplished by the statutory deadline. So if that works, I would ask that the board adopt those dates and we will advertise them.
Is there also need to work for so the first or Thursday, September 10th at 5:30, where is that?
Judicial Annex.
Judicial Annex is what I just said. The second one, 22nd at Coliseum, is that also 5:30?
5:30.
Okay. Thank you.
Are you good, Commissioner Richardson?
Yes, sir.
If I was sure everybody else at this point, that's what we'll do. That'll be fine.
Okay. Thank you.
Mr. Walden, not with us this evening.
That's a question.
I believe
Walter here, I didn't see him.
I don't see him.
That's fine, we'll do an update next Tuesday, okay? We have covered both of our additional agenda items at this time.
No, sir. You have, oh, you covered both, you only covered one. There's a second one on there. The second one on there, Mr. Chair.
There was just an addition to it. We'll discuss it. Correct.
Yes, sir, you approved the chip seal, the use of the chip seal funds, this is simply going ahead and approving, authorizing us to piggyback on a contract we already have in Anderson, Columbia to pay that road.
Okay, my apologies. At this time, do I have a motion to authorize for the purpose of paying a portion of this road?
Motion to approve.
Got a motion by Commissioner Gamble, second by Commissioner Clement, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Thank you, Mr. Harris. Apologies for that. At this time, I will open the floor to public comments. Do I have anyone from the public who should speak? If you do, please make your way to the front. Seeing none, I will close public comments at this time. Mr. Harris, do you have anything additional?
No, sir.
At this time, we'll have closed comments. Mr. Pratt?
Nothing, Mr. Chairman.
Thanks, sir.
Well, let me back up. I would like to bring one thing to the attention of the board. I spoke earlier with Mr. Musgrove about this, and it's been about the publication, and what will happen with the upcoming trip notices and other things that are happening. It's been, difficult, going through this process, and without a newspaper, there are certain things we have to do, and we discussed it last time without publication in the adjoining county. But it's come to our attention that there's another publisher that is going to be starting up here in the county very shortly. And as a result, we have a publisher for a paper, but there are other requirements that go along with the publication. If you do not have a newspaper that is currently in your county, and a new one starts up, if it has not been in operation for over a year's time, it's the only one that's available, and if it otherwise qualifies with the other things that you have to do to be qualified, yours was breaking up too, but if it otherwise qualifies, for those other categories, it gets taken out from underneath some of the rules, so that if this new paper started, we could start publication in paper according to 50.041 and 50.051. However, we have now to deal with legal notices, and legal notices for a proof of publication, which is included in 5.1 and in 6.1. And there's a specific form, and it's legislatively determined, and there's no altering it. And the form includes in it a provision that it has been published by a newspaper, for such and such a period of time. And the only way that your statutes or ordinances or trip notices or anything are approved or are not void automatically is by having this affidavit published. In other words, I'm circling way back around because I'm trying to get us so that we can get to publish in the paper here. But I personally don't believe it qualifies right now, but I would like to have your permission to send a real quick letter over to the Attorney General to get some clarification on the affidavit part of that.
You need that in motion?
Please, sir.
So, motion.
Second.
Got a motion by Commissioner Clement, second by Commissioner Richardson. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. You sure you're good, Mr. Harrison? You look like something's on your mind. Okay. This time we'll have closing comments from our board. Commissioner Richardson?
Don't have to thank you.
Mr. Clemens?
Okay.
Sir?
Mr. Gavin?
I don't have anything to answer.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Harrison?
I just got one thing. There was, I think we had some pretty active breaks last week. And I spoke about one of them. I happened to come along and it was a very bad accident. You guys may have heard about 129, 429. But I just wanted to let the sheriff know and the chief man know that I was there, one of the first people there. And our staff was amazing. It was a bad situation, but it's the first time I was able to witness what they do, how they do. And I just want to say I was impressed by that. I'm thankful for the employees we have. Both sheriff department and our fire department. So, thank you.
That'll be that, sir. Thank you. All that I have left tonight is I just appreciate everyone coming out and support us, appreciate the county, all the work that goes into this time of year when it comes to budgets, all our staff, and then all our people. It's a lot of them right now. Just have to push forward. We have a closing quote for tonight by Mr. Winston Churchill. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue.